In statistics, we are charged with taking data and using them to create a model. One of the most widely used statistical approaches is maximum likelihood estimation. And so in today's video, I want to introduce you to the idea of maximum likelihood estimation and help explain the ways that we use it to estimate a model from data. Now let's introduce maximum likelihood estimation by looking at the following situation. A stranger offers you a bet. You'll flip a coin, and if the coin is tails, you'll win $5. Alternatively, if the coin is heads, they'll win $5. Now you decide to take on this bet, and four times in a row, the coin pops up heads. You're now down $20 and trying to make sense of the situation. And so you ask yourself, what is the likelihood that this could have even happened? And perhaps more importantly, should you continue gambling away your savings? Now take a moment and reflect on the answer to this question. How likely was this occurring? A very reasonable first answer to this question might be 1 in 16. And that is a really good starting point and answer. Now we'll shortly discuss in this video why this might have not been the case. But if you did assume that it was 1 in 16, how did you come up with that answer? The likely way that you came up with that is you said to yourself, there's a 50% chance of heads on the first toss, a 50% chance on the second, and the third, and the fourth. And so let's multiply these probabilities together, and that gives us 1 in 16. Now, if you did that, you actually invoked two really important principles around probability and statistics. And I've provided a link in the description to a previously published video where I discussed these concepts in detail. The first of these principles that you invoked was independence, and that is the occurrence of one event has no bearing on the probability of another event. In this situation, the probability that heads would occur on the second toss you've assumed is independent of what happened on the first toss. And if you invoke this principle, the probability of getting four heads in a row is equal to the probability of each individual event multiplied with each other. Now, the second assumption that you've made is that these observations are coming from the exact same distribution, and we refer to this as being identically distributed. And so the probability of getting heads on the first toss is exactly the same as on the second toss, and it's the same on the third, and it's the same on the fourth, and that's just equal to 1/2. And so because you previously assumed independence, which told you that the probability of getting four heads in a row is equal to the product, or the multiplication of each of these individual probabilities, and you've assumed each is 1/2, then the probability of getting four heads was just 1/2 raised to the fourth. So now that we understand how you might come up with the answer 1 in 16, let's introduce this concept of a likelihood function. And let's keep in mind that the observations are fixed. You've observed that the coin has been tossed four times, and again, four heads have shown up. Now we said earlier that the chance of this occurring was 1 in 16, and the way that we did that was we assumed that when you toss the coin, there was a 50% chance of it being heads and a 50% chance of it being tails. But let's consider the fact now that all you really know are the four outcomes. You don't actually know if this was a fairly weighted coin. The probability on an individual toss of it being heads-tails indeed could have been 50-50, but it could have been 100% zero. It could have been 3/4, 1/4. You don't actually know what is the underlying probability unless you were to inspect the coin being tossed. So now let's consider the probability of being heads and tails being uncertain, and let's consider that the probability of it being heads is p, and therefore the probability of it being tails is 1 minus p. So if it was 100% heads, it would be 0% tails. 3/4 heads, 1/4 tails. And p is this parameter that we're trying to figure out and solve for. So now that we understand the context in the situation, let's introduce this mathematical concept, which is a likelihood function. And a likelihood function just represents the likelihood of obtaining a set of observations as a function of the parameters for the underlying model. In other words, if we play around with this parameter p, how likely would it have been that we would have observed what we have observed? And so in a likelihood function, what we're basically doing is creating a plot where on the y-axis, we're representing the likelihood of the outcomes observed as a function of the parameter for the underlying model. And what we've done is we've computed the likelihood of this sequence for one possible parameter value. P equals 1/2, we said, leads to a 1 in 16 chance of this occurring. This, of course, was based on the assumption of independence as well as identically distributed observations. And so what we can do now is generalize the way that we came up with that 1 in 16 answer earlier and say that the likelihood of this sequence is now just p to the fourth, where p again is the probability of heads. So now let's create that likelihood function plot where we're plotting the likelihood of this sequence as a function of the parameter p. And p, of course, can range between 0 and 1. P equaling 0 is the case of the coin being tails-tails, 100% chance that the outcome will be tails, and 0% chance that the outcome will be heads. On the other side, we have the extreme of the coin being heads-heads. Every time it's flipped, the observation should be heads. And P equals 1/2 represents the situation where it's a fair coin, 50% chance heads, 50% chance tails. And so now let's add to this plot the likelihood function as a function of P. And in this particular situation, as we increase P, the likelihood function tends to increase. And that makes sense because remember, P is the probability of it being heads. And so if I increase the probability associated with the coin giving me the result heads, it is more likely that I would have observed what I have observed in this particular situation. And if P was equal to 1, that is, it's a coin where on both sides of it is heads, there is a 100% chance I would have observed what I've observed. And so hopefully this idea of a likelihood function makes sense. What we're saying here is that we have a model, the parameters are unknown, but we have the set of observations, and we're trying to map out how likely the observations would have occurred as a function of what the model parameters were. It's a really hard concept to understand at first, but the main thing we have to wrap our heads around is that the outcomes and the observations are set and known, but the underlying model is not. That is what we're trying to figure out. But now that we've done this, we can now conduct maximum likelihood estimation. According to maximum likelihood estimation, what we want to do is for our model, select the parameters that maximize this likelihood function. And so based on this plot, if P is equal to 1, in other words, we're flipping a coin that is heads on both sides, that maximizes the likelihood function. And so how cool is that? Through this problem, you have been able to implement a challenging mathematical concept, the idea of creating a likelihood function, and furthermore, determining the parameters that maximize it. And so based on this, let's go back to the original question underlying this video. How likely was this occurrence, and should you continue gambling away your savings? At the start of this video, you may have very well thought that the chance of this occurring was 1 in 16, or 6.25%, which is rare, but not outside the realm of possibilities. Now, through coming up with this likelihood function and determining the situation that maximizes it, you now think that the chance of this occurring was actually 100%, and you should probably stop taking on this bet, which is guaranteed to lose you money. Now, here is probably the most frustrating aspect of the question that I asked you in this video. At the end of this analysis, we actually don't truly know with 100% certainty the true nature of this coin. Yes, we have come up with a likelihood function, and yes, that likelihood function can help explain the likelihood of this sequence occurring as a function of the nature of the coin. But as we saw with the likelihood function, there is a non-zero likelihood of four heads showing up for all values of P except for actually just one. The case of it being zero, the case of the coin being tails-tails. And this highlights a really important aspect of both maximum likelihood estimation as well as statistics broadly. That is, we're using data to come up with a model and its parameters, but the true model is unknown. What we're trying to do is make sense of the data as best we can to come up with a good model that can support us in answering important questions to us. So congratulations. If you understood this video, you can now understand one of the more important statistical principles, likelihood methods, and maximum likelihood estimation that shows up in many applications. Thank you as always for your interest. I look forward to seeing you soon.